And hello to today's little game. 15 PT, 5K. Today with one legend. The one everybody might have heard of or not. If you didn't heard of him, you were clearly too fast. Today we have Adel in the game, which is quite a surprise. Didn't expect he would make it because, as we know, he's so fast, he actually looks pretty slow. Which is the main reason why we don't see him. Anyway, yeah, basic game today, classic Call of Duty, and yeah. Not much to say during the peacetime. I'm a little bit tired, but it's late, so I guess you could understand that. And before anybody asks in the comments, I'm still Ricardo. I'm not some kind of morpher. I don't just change into Call of It. Which wouldn't be quite fun, as I imagine. I wouldn't like to switch bodies with color. I would be full of tea. And that's not exactly my target. Anyway, today we got Call of It, the legend, the slowest Adel, and Furio and me against my young citizens, King Alavaki. I hope I didn't botch that, and I'm Havaya. Possibly going to be quite interesting, I'm not sure. It seems to be pretty balanced though. At least from what I could tell. Already some chat banter going on. As usual, it's the case with the Call of It games. Yeah, and the streams, of course, there's always got to be some kind of banter. Thank you. And we already have some classics going on. The classical call of it memes. The call of it making plans. Me stating they are awful. And him stating then again that he doesn't care. Good that some things doesn't change. Don't change, I mean. It looks like me and Collar are going to have to fight Andrea and citizens. Or better said, we'll defend against them for a while. Though, with the actual look of the things, I might even get my upgrades in time. So we don't even have to stay back. But we'll see how it turns out. And Call of it is promoting an aggressive attack on your right flank. There's a little bit of sluggish movement going on though. Which it's normal because Adel is there. And as I previously stated, he's so fast that he actually looks slow for us. But that's only optical illusions, I tell you. He is really fast. Lightning has nothing against him. He's just going to outrun it. Meanwhile, it's on our side, there's a little bit of an attack going in there. Pair. I kind of wanted to send Toll, but I don't have this Toll. I'm still going to send it, even though it's going to be my downfall. And I hope that Call of Duty actually uses his men on my flank to defend against the Queen attack. Because I have to order my men to defend against purple. And my men are engaging with the forces of purple, however I have fully upgraded musketeers, so they should put down a lot of damage. I don't know why, but Colorful completely fell back on the flank with the green, which means that my poor reinforcements are going to get destroyed. And my third barracks apparently as well. However, it's not like I couldn't afford another one. I'm quite rich at this point. Apart from the fact that I don't have any ammunition to shoot because I had to give Call of the Man ammunition. For some reason Einreier is just charging his dragoons into my highly skilled musketeers. Utterly destroyed. I've only lost like 8 men in this attack. Any resistance that now comes up against me is futile. The enemy is now trying to use dragoons against my brave lad lads. And Adel is requesting some coal, so I give him that coal. My army got crushed by some dragoons. Unfortunate, but I already have another army ready. But for some reason my men think it's a good idea to charge in against my command. Might actually not be the worst thing in the world though. The telephone just got squashed as well. It's not very beneficial to our cause. However, since the enemy appears to just be charging into our lines, it should be quite easy. Actually, now they are falling back. And the Dutch are engaging me apparently. Interesting strategy, however I don't think it's going to pay off for them. Considering that I have my epic archers and they don't have any archers. For some reason I still lost though. And I don't exactly know why. The raider fence on the right side has failed, however. It seems like we are all a bit tired because Colovin is getting his lines intercepted from the purple dragoons. Yeah, Amy apparently isn't noticing my little resistance movement. Which is good for me and bad for them, because they are losing some men. Even though it's not a lot, it's still going to have a bit. Now using mercenary grenadiers. One reason more why I don't know why I should have made drilling upgrades, yet I did them. People seem to ignore the power of the mine explosion today. Apart from me and Color, of course. There was a massive explosion of the coal mine. It killed quite a few marketeers. The slowest cavalrymen have arrived. Right? The time to be too late for the battle. But we all know they were actually so fast they just went around the world too much, so they arrived too late at the real battle. The enemy is going to be pushed outside of my base. And there's a big engagement on the right side. Which there's only the Dutch engaging immediately, giving Adel and Apulio a big advantage, considering they have Prussian musketeers and Seki musketeers. But the latter are not engaging because Adel's men have been staying back too much. So it's pretty much even, to be honest. However, now Adel's forces are engaging as well. Hashtag and Seiki musketeers, mixed with the Prussian musketeers. Might actually result in a pretty easy win now. And it's going to be because there's a bunch of Hussars from Antulio coming in. So for these two should push now. They have massive forces on their hands. Now there's a big cavalry army coming in from the yellow player, from my Yank. And a big purple army as well. Now the right side has been smashed again. And it looks The guy in the is also going to take major damage, which I already majorly damaged him before when I was not crippled. However, I think I've recovered quite well. With 4 turn holds instead of 3 now. My archers are inflicting major damage on the purple formations. Fortunately, the purple player didn't quite send his cavalry in. So they are going to be quite a piece of cake for the leftover army. My archers are now inflicting heavy damage on the base troops of purple due to their superior range and their capability to somehow damage multiple targets at once, which is a kind of a gimmick in with archers, I think. At least archers always seem to inflict major damage against enemy formations, especially if they're densely packed. enemy reinforcements of green are getting heavily shelled by my archers. And my anchors quit. And this game appears to be almost over, basically. It took an entire hour now. And I think at this point it's quite a good point to inform all of you that the new Call of the Tournament registration has started. You can find the link if you want to participate, or if you don't want to participate and just want to talk to other Cossacks players. You can find the link to the Discord in the video description below. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this battle. It was quite long. It was quite changing battle. It was quite a comeback from Color's side and everybody else's side. I only got destroyed, but I still inflicted some major damage with the archers. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you probably in the weekend, because actually maybe I'm going to play in the tournament as well, and I'm going to prepare my own team, so you might actually see me. And until then, have a nice week and enjoy it. Bye bye.